Good evening. I am Mrs. Aradhana Rana, the founder principal of the Icon Public School, Ahmednagar. Ahmednagar is a B-class city near Pune. So the challenges that we face in cities like this are a little different to the challenges faced by schools in the metro cities. Parents are more tech savvy and I think more aware in metro cities. So it's a little easier to deal with them. But in places like this, we have teachers who have to be trained and parents who have to be educated on this kind of teaching. A lot of people have talked about the impact of COVID-19 on education. But today I'm going to focus more on the positives of this calamity. It has come as a calamity, and I think the definition of intelligence is to adapt to circumstances, and this is what we should do. What we have we cannot change, but how we adapt to it is what shows how intelligent we are. So what we'll focus on is what I think is the positives that have come out of it. Now, what COVID has done to the education system actually was needed a long time ago, but somehow we got so busy in our routine and we got so comfortable with it that change was coming a bit slow. And I don't think COVID just accelerated this change. That is all that it has done. It was bound to come sometime or the other. The world is changing. It is becoming very, very tech related, and there is no way that India can lag behind. But when it came, it just threw us, all teachers, all students, we were just thrown into the sea. And I must tell you, we learned to swim. We learned to swim beautifully. I remember the day this lockdown was announced, suddenly everybody went into shock as to when schools would open and what would happen and examinations. And then we just had the staff meeting, and I realized that it was within 15 minutes that everybody adapted. And we, in unison, we came up with this thing of online teaching and getting trained, getting evolved. So it was, I think, towards the end of the meeting, we had discussed our strategy, we had planned how to go about it. And the first thing we did was to announce vacations. So when it was vacations, the children did not feel that they were not attending school. We told them it was a holiday and we would open on the 1st of May. So it gave us this 1 month plus of little breather, and the teachers straight away dived into work. Now these teachers for that matter, and most of us, we were very unfamiliar with the Zoom meetings and this kind of technology. But how fast we adapted, we learned. This few young teachers, they knew, they educated the rest, and all of us struggled, all of us worked, and within 15 days we were holding Zoom meetings and we were discussing, we were innovating, we were creating. And to keep the children busy, we declared a create and win contest where they had to make videos on any creative talents. We gave them categories and they were posting. Now this was mainly, we were most concerned about the mental, emotional health of the children. So we wanted to keep them involved. But I think the good that came out of it was that the bonding between parents, teachers and children actually improved. Because the parents realized how involved the children, the teachers were in the lives of the children, how important they were. So this is how I think we built up relationships, which was really nice. Now I feel with this COVID-19 being a part of our lives, not only us, the schools, the whole society has to change. The government has to change its policies. The whole education system, the examination system, it will go through a tremendous change. The kind of examinations we used to have, I don't think we can have them anymore. So what is going to evolve from this is online tests, our open book tests. So now these are the things which test creativity, which test originality, which test actual intelligence of the students. The whole system of learning by rote and vomiting it out on paper is going to go away. And this is how teachers will learn to create question papers. It's actually more difficult to create an open book question paper. So teachers are going to have to read a lot, to be more informed, not be restricted to syllabus. So this is a whole a lot of good. I have heard a lot of criticism about online teaching for rural areas. Firstly, let me tell you, urban areas, whether it is metros or cities like ours, there is actually no problem in online teaching. People have the gadgets, they may not have that kind of awareness, but children are very tech savvy. They have taken to it like fish to water. They are really, good at it. They are in fact instructing the teachers how to, if there is a glitch, the students are there to help, which is, I think, a wonderful thing, and they will adapt to it very, very fast. Secondly, the best thing that has come out of this online teaching method is the responsibility I see with the students. They have learned to be honest because the assessment is self-assessment, and they know that it's for their good. They have learned to be responsible because they are now exploring on their own. They are innovating. They are reading on their own. Language is improving because they have to read. There's nothing spoon-fed to them. So these are the things which are positives. Whereas the rural areas are concerned, the government will have to alter its policies if it can give so much of freebies to people below poverty line or others based on caste, based on anything. I'm sure it can give some kind of gadgets to school children. Gadgets do not have to be very expensive. They do not have to be the latest smartphones. They can be they can probably develop some gadgets just based on learning. The companies like Reliance and others, they can come up with solutions to the internet problems. If we can, if all of India can get mobile phones, I'm sure this will be the need of the hour, they'll get it. Necessity is the mother of invention. We will, come up with ideas and innovations to meet these requirements. So these kind of innovative ideas, when children, evolve from this, you will see that we'll come up with more scientists, more thinkers, more authors, more poets. So, people will start using their mind. It is just not knowledge based on books. Also, the syllabus has to be altered. There is actually no need for many things that we study. They are not life skills. So we will have to come towards life skills, maybe reduce the syllabus a bit, but increase the dependence on exploration, on doing, on practical work. These are the things which will evolve from this so-called calamity, which I think is an opportunity. So as long as we maintain a positive attitude and we think of a new world order, which will be much better than the old one, I think we'll do fine. And one day we shall, I think, land up thanking the coronavirus for doing us good. You see the nature, how it's evolved. The animals, nature, clean air, everything is good. So will the education system be very, very positive. So thank you so much.